Hey everyone, welcome back. This is just a quick video about how to interpret gel electrophoresis results when it comes to different types of plasmid DNA. Just as different sizes of DNA run at different rates through a gel, different plasmid conformations run differently as well. So that's what we're talking about. I'll first talk about the structure of agarose as well as plasmid conformations, and then we can kind of dive into interpreting your results. All right, so in order to interpret your gel electrophoresis results, we first need to look at the structure of agarose. When you're looking at your gel, it's going to look like a gel. But here's an illustration of a conceptual rendering of how agarose looks at more of a microscopic level. It's mesh-like, very porous, and that porous structure impacts how DNA moves through the gel. Smaller, more compact DNA will be able to travel easier and therefore further down the lane in a given runtime. Larger, less compact DNA is going to get caught up and therefore travel slowly and therefore a shorter distance through the gel in a given time. I like to use an example here of moving a couch through a doorway versus a small chair through a doorway. It won't be nearly as difficult to move a small chair through a doorway, whereas a couch, you know how couch moving goes. Now, when it comes to answering questions about how plasmid DNA will appear in your gel, we need to look at different conformations of plasmid DNA. Though a sample of plasmid could all be the exact same size, the different conformations can actually cause them to run through the gel at different speeds. Common conformations are nicked open circular DNA where one of the strands is cut, and this cut or nick relaxes the tension, making the conformation a lot less compact. The next conformation is linear DNA, and this is where both strands of DNA have been cut, and therefore the DNA is linearized. And then there's supercoil DNA, or also called covalently closed circular DNA. Supercoil DNA is where both strands are still intact, with twisting causing the DNA to be a lot more compact. And the order of these conformations go from the least compact to the most compact, and that's going to influence how they run within a gel. So now let's kind of take what we learned and sort of apply it here, just dive a little deeper. Remember that agarose has a porous structure, and these pores create obstacles for the DNA. The more compact DNA is, the easier time it will have getting through these pores. So therefore, considering these conformations of plasmids, the nicked open circular structure, which is more relaxed and therefore less compact, this isn't going to travel quite as far through the gel during a given time. Linear DNA of the same size will travel further though than that nicked open circular DNA. And then finally, supercoil DNA, which is more compact, is going to travel the furthest down a lane. Hopefully this helps you better understand how you would interpret the results of your gel electrophoresis when it comes to plasmid DNA. Remember, the takeaways here are that agarose is porous, larger DNA will have a harder time maneuvering through the pores than smaller DNA will. Finally, less compact DNA, such as that relaxed, nicked, open circular DNA, will have a harder time maneuvering through those pores as well. And that's compared to the more compact DNA, like supercoil DNA, which will move a lot easier. Again, I hope this video helped. If it did, be sure to give it a like. That also helps us out too. And don't forget to subscribe to keep seeing more content like this and other videos geared towards life science research. Be sure also to check out goldbio.com for access to high quality research reagents and just a ton more other resources. Thank you all so much for watching.